Hey everyone, welcome to our YouTube channel for Nurses Preparation. I am Neeraj Kumar Kaithal. From now, we are starting a new video series. In this series, all videos contain 11 important questions for upcoming staff nurse exams. This is part 1. Let's begin. First question. A failure in lymphatic system to return body fluids adequately result in swelling of hands and leg, swelling of face and hands, edema in spleen, swelling of tissues as edema. The right answer is option C. If lymphatic system fails in returning the body fluids adequately, it results in edema in spleen. Next. Extra space in between the patient's room and main corridor of hospital will help in option A, less contamination of room articles, option B, reduced flow of airborne pathogens, option C, patient will be less disturbed, option D, nurse will have place for things. The right answer is option B. Reduced flow of airborne pathogens. Next, genetic disorders are classified under following except option A, chromosomal abnormalities, genetic abnormalities, unifactorial diseases, multifactorial diseases. The right answer is option B, genetic abnormalities. Genetic disorders can be classified under chromosomal abnormalities, unifactorial diseases, multifactorial diseases. Next, retaining permanent change in behavior that occurs as a result of prior experiences is known as education, aptitude, learning, intelligence. The right answer is option C, learning. With the help of learning, we can make permanent change in behavior. The phenomena in society in which people move up and down and vice versa on social scale is known as social status, social class, social classification, social mobility. The right answer is option D, social mobility. Next. If patient is on IV, it is important for the nurse to check the tubing for nodes and clots so that theme is no swelling, no pain at site, patient is not comfortable, fluid flow at proper rate. The right answer is option D, fluid flow at proper rate. Nurse should be alert for following complications after patient has undergone bronchoscopy: bronchitis, hemoptysis, pneumonitis, pneumothorax. The right answer is option D, pneumothorax. Pneumothorax is a possible complication that may occur after bronchoscopy. In case child of 2 years manifest with chest indrawing, wheezing, fever, nurse will option A, give antibiotics and advise home care, option B, do assessment and give antibiotics, option C, give treatment for fever and advise home care, option D, treat for fever, wheezing, give antibiotics and refer. The right answer is option D, treat for fever, wheezing, give antibiotics and refer. Next, during assessment, nurse observed signs of fetal distress, she immediately option A, if on oxytocin, stop it and start IV and oxygen. Option B, inform doctor, start IV and oxytocin. Option C, stop oxytocin and inform doctor. Option D, shift the patient in OT with IV. The right answer is option A. If on oxytocin, stop it, start IV and oxygen. Next, to avoid the infection during IV infusion, the nurse should change IV site and assessment, cover the needle site and check vitals, check and cover needle site and change IV bottles 24 hourly. Assessment of site and check vitals. The right answer is option C. Check and cover needle site and change IV bottles 24 hourly. Next, the degree to which one can conclude that it was the interventional variable, not the extraneous variable that produced the change in dependent variables is known as content validity, external validity, construct validity, internal validity. The right answer is option D, internal validity. Thank you so much for watching this complete video, friends. Its next part will be published soon.